Do you want to cut through all of the confusion about how to treat pests and diseases in your garden? Well, there's only five items that you're really going to need to treat about 95% of the problem. Got a little confession to make. This year, got a little bit cocky in the garden because I thought I had it dialed in. I mean, there was no problems. Everything was growing like it was supposed to. I did what I was supposed to. No bugs, no pests, no diseases. And I was thinking, I'm king of the garden. Then Mother Nature stepped in and went, nope. So in about 2 to 3 days, we had torrential rains. Then the air temps came up about 12, 15 degrees. Humidity went up to about 80%. And then in came the bugs, the pests, and the diseases. In about 48 hours, my garden changed from something that was absolutely perfect to something completely and totally under attack. So we're gonna go out and take a look at what just happened. But while I was doing this, I was thinking, there's five things that I keep here on the farm that solve about 95% of most of my gardening problems. And I've got them here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the problems that we're facing, and then I'm going to show you the products that I'm using and how I can do it, and probably some of the products that you need to keep at your place too. First thing I noticed was on my Roma tomatoes. They were looking really good. I mean, there's still a ton of fruit on here, but then I started seeing some black spots. Saw those black spots going onto the stem. They have a distinctive look. The mature leaves towards the bottom were starting to die off. They had the same spots. Guess what? Early blight. Super proud of my eggplants. They were growing fantastic. Then a couple of them started drooping a little bit in the leaves. Looked a little closer, saw some cracking of the stems, beetles, aphids. We're gonna have to deal with those. Our beefsteak tomatoes, a source of southern pride, our Cherokee purples, started showing some cracks. What caused it? How do we fix it? Another eggplant, this one's in a container. The leaves, they look like Swiss cheese. Caterpillars all over the place. And last night, to make matters worse, I saw a pickle worm. If you're a beginner gardener, this does sound a little overwhelming. I mean, my Romas are blighty, my eggplants are buggy, my Cherokee purples are splitting, my other eggplant is wormy, and then I've got caterpillars over in my cucumbers. Yeah, but it can all be solved. Let's go take a look. All right, before we get into this, make sure that you follow all the manufacturer's directions. And also, this video, we're not going to get into detail of what type of beetle it's going to be or what type of mold, spore, or fungus it is. Basically, the way we're looking at it is if it's a bug eating your plant, kill it. If it's a mold or spore or fungus that's killing your plant, kill it. Let's talk about my early blight or any fungus that I see in my garden and how I'm going to treat it. We're going to use a copper fungicide. Now, the stuff that I use is this stuff right here, and it is from Captain's Jack's. It is an organic fungicide, and all I'm going to do with this stuff is we're going to take, it's super blue, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 ounces per gallon of water. Now, I use a 2-gallon sprayer, which I've got right here ready to go. I'll just take my 2-gallon sprayer, and to make sure that you label your sprayers, I've got about 3 or 4 of them that I use for different things. So I'm filled this up halfway already. I'm just gonna add my 4 ounces of copper algicide, and then I'm gonna finish filling it up with the other gallon of water, and then I'm gonna mix this up really, really well. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply this directly to the plants. I'm gonna put it underneath the leaves and on top of the leaves, and then I'm going to go ahead and start reapplying that about every 7 to 10 days until I can get those tomatoes harvested. If you start seeing fungus in your garden, then I would recommend going ahead and just start treating it. Now, this is one of those weird instructions as far as a gardener goes. They tell you to start applying this 2 weeks before the fungus hits. Well, I don't have a crystal ball, and I don't know. Just go ahead and start applying it when the temperatures start to rise, the humidity starts to increase, and you're going to be fine. And apply it every 10 to 14 days. That way you know that you're going to keep everything under control. Also, you can do this up to the day of your harvest, so you're going to be absolutely fine with this for controlling your funguses. Now let's talk about killing bugs directly. Have an insecticidal soap on hand. Now you can make this with stuff that you probably already have at your house. You can use a Castile type soap. You can use a little bit of vegetable oil and just some water. What you'll do is you'll mix 4 tablespoons of this Castile soap. This is a Dr. Bronner's, and then I stole this from my wife in the kitchen, and this is just vegetable oil. I'll put in 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil. I'll put it into a quart spray bottle, shake it up really well, and then when I see the bugs, I'm gonna go ahead and spray them directly. It's going to suffocate those bugs, and it's gonna kill them right away. Now, another organic direct contact insecticide that you can use is this right here. This is from Garden Safe. Now, this has a pyrethrin in it. I think I said that correctly. Basically, it's the oil that comes from a chrysanthemum plant and is highly toxic to your aphids, your beetles, your slugs. It works very, very well. This is something that you can just get at your local garden centers, or you can get it from the link below. Once you see them, spray it directly. It's going to kill them really quick. It's not going to be immediate. It may take a few minutes or so, but this is something that you definitely want to have in your tool belt when you walk out to your garden. Now let's talk about two different types of organic insecticide that we use in our garden, because there's two different types of bugs. There's a crunchy bug and a squishy bug. I told you it was going to be kind of unscientific. A crunchy bug is going to be something like an aphid or a beetle, something when you step on it, it goes crunch. Then you have a squishy bug, something like a caterpillar or a slug, when you step on it, it goes squish. There's two different types of bugs, two different types of insecticides that we're going to be using organically. The first one, let's talk about the crunchy bugs. So our aphids, our beetles, we're going to be using this product here. Now this is Neem, and it comes from Captain Jack's. It comes from the same place where we get our copper fungicide. Now this is a 70% cold pressed neem oil. It is completely organic. Now I like this the best because there are other neem oils that are already pre-mixed there, but it's not the cold pressed 100% neem, so I'm not really 100% confident and it works. I've been using this for years, so this is what I always use. Now I will take this and I will mix 2.5 ounces per gallon of water in one of my sprayers, which is over here. Since I've got aphids, I'm going to treat them just like that. Now I already have this filled up halfway. I'm going to put in 2 tablespoons of my neem oil. Now I've already put in about 1/2 gallon in here, so it starts the dilution process a little bit better, and then I'm just going to fill it up. And then the way that I'm going to use this is I'm going to do it just the same way I did my fungicide. I am going to spray the leaves so they're saturated underneath and on top of the plant. And I'm going to do that every other week. And the way that we're going to apply neem, now if there's guys that are out there have heard about neem oil and how it kills bees, there was a study that done that they can be toxic to bees. Well, if the bees drink it directly, yes, it can kill them. But the way that you apply neem is you're going to put it on, just like all of these, put it on either super early in the morning or late in the evening. That way our pollinators aren't out, they're not busy, and this is going to soak into the plant in about 3 hours. So if you're going to do it in the evening, the pollinators are going to be gone, it's going to absorb into the plant, and it's going to take care of it. Now the next thing we're going to talk about is going to be our squishy bugs. Now our squishy bugs, we use something like this. This is called BT. Now I could give you the scientific name for it, but quite frankly I'd screw it up and you probably wouldn't remember it. Just remember BT. Now BT actually occurs naturally in the soil, and what it does, it also gets soaked into the leaves and it disrupts the hormonal cycle inside of our caterpillars and our slugs. It causes them to stop breeding so they can't live, and it'll also cause them to die. So this will also get applied about every week or so that I have out in my garden. So that's the 5 things we keep here in the garden that takes care of 95% of our problems. Number one, the copper fungicide soap. When I start seeing my plants sick from disease or fungus, I'm going to use that. Number two is going to be my insecticidal soap that I'm going to make here at the house. Number three is going to be my direct contact spray. Number four is going to be my neem. And number five is going to be my BT. The majority of that's going to cover the majority of your plants. Now, here's the system that we use in order to keep pests down in our garden. Now, you may have something a little bit different. As a matter of fact, if you have a different insecticide or a different fungicide that you've used, please share it in the comments section below. The system that we use is really quite simple. We will alternate. 1 week is going to be neem, 1 week is going to be BT, and we'll continue to do that up until the week before harvest, and then we stop. With our fungicide, we're going to put that on about 2 weeks prior to the humidity level coming up, and then we're going to apply that every 2 weeks. When I see the bugs out, I'm going to kill them directly with either one of these two. Well, that's what we use here in the garden. I hope this is beneficial to you. If you use something different, please leave in the comment section below. Let us know what your results are. Share it with everybody. I'm Greg from Bell's Backyard. Hope to see you in the backyard soon.